Hello everybody and welcome to this channel. On this episode I'm going to introduce to you an ancient city known as Persepolis, so stay tuned. Persepolis is a collection of several palaces next to the Marv Dasht plain at the foothill of Rahmat mountain located in Marv Dasht city. This place is 1,770 meters above sea level and was built on a stone platform 18 meters higher than the ground level. The total floor area of its palaces is 125,000 square meters. Persepolis was served as the ceremonial capital of the Achaemenid Empire for 200 years and was situated in the ancient place of Parse, one of the historical cities of Iran. The construction of this part was initiated in 518 BC under Darius the Great and expanded by the successors over 120 years. The entrance includes 111 wide and short steps with 10 centimeters height on each side to allow beasts of burden could climb them as well. Above the steps, the Gate of Nation is located. The height of this structure is 10 meters and includes one main entrance and two exits. Winged men statues adorn the western and eastern gates. In this section, stone pillars are crowned with bullheads. The symbol of Zoroastrianism, known as Faravahar, and six cuneiform inscriptions are engraved on this part that mention the name of Ahura Mazda, the supreme god, in ancient Persian religion. Among the remaining and semi-ruined buildings adjacent to the main entrance, Apadana Palace lies and consists of a central hall with 36 columns and three 12-column porches in the northern, southern, and eastern parts, two of which are connected by stairs to the opposite yards. Apadana Palace is one of the oldest edifices in Persepolis. This part, which was built by the order of Darius the Great, was used to hold Persian holidays and receive representatives from other countries. This part is a square, 60 meters is its side length, and its roof is supported by 36 columns with a height of 18 meters. This section is connected to the Mirror Palace by a staircase in its southwest part. Mirror or Tacharo Palace was the winter residence of the monarch. The floor area of this part is 1,160 square meters and 12 columns have been used in this section plus a central square room with a side of 15 meters. Its foundation is built on a stone platform with a height of 2.5 meters. This structure was also built at the behest of Darius the Great, but the other parts were added by his successors. The plastered cornices, based on Egyptian models and polished statues, are among the exceptional parts of this building. The central hall used to have two human head statues in its entrance, which were not found in other places. The human head was a symbol of thinking, and therefore this building is called the Council Palace as well. According to the archaeologists' belief, The king possibly used this part to convene a meeting with his counselors. Hadish Palace, the royal residence of Xerxes, is situated in the highest part of Persepolis and connected to the queen's palace through two sets of stairs. This section is located in the southernmost part of the stone platform, and nearly all of the floor materials are from the mountain. During the invasion of enemies, possibly this building at first was set on fire. The yellow color of the stones indicates that the water inside of them has run out due to the heat of the fire. The last royal residence was known as the 100 Column Palace, with a floor area of 4,300 square meters, and its roof was supported by stone pillars. Each of them was 14 meters high. The treasury consists of two colonnaded halls, several corridors, rooms, and two backyards. This building was the largest treasury of the Achaemenids that was separated from other palaces by a stone wall and was built by the order of Darius the Great. In the past scientific excavations in this part, most of the dishes, statues, and especially the famous 8 stone tablets of Xerxes carved in cuneiform and Elamite language were found. After the fall of Persepolis during the invasion of Persia led by Alexander Macedonian, gold, silver, and other valuables of this treasury have been looted. In the petroglyphs of Persepolis, there is a diverse array of figures. Each of them has distinctive characteristics that depict societal hierarchy and cultural nuances of the era. For instance, having a lotus flower in the left hand is a sign of high status. Grooved hats indicate high ranking in the army. Simple long hats are symbols of prominence, and short cylindrical hats are used by the royal guards. Apadana Palace has two sets of stairs. Each of them has carved figures depicting the high-ranking Median and Persian military commanders. The members of the royal guard that stand in lines regularly and pay respects to the king. Representatives from different countries, accompanied by other groups of people carrying gifts and approaching the palace. Carvings on the walls of Mirror Palace show a group of hunters carrying prey and dishes to set up a feast. In other parts, you can observe the trees and floral patterns, in addition to several high-detailed statues of animals. A bas-relief discovered in the treasury shows Xerxes sitting on the throne in official attires. Behind the king, the crown prince, one of the courtiers, a personal weapon carrier and royal guards are standing respectively. There are two incense burners in front of the king, and the chief of ceremonies reports respectfully. According to the archaeologists' research, among the clay inscriptions that have been read so far, some important matters were identified, including the salary payment system, the type of materials used in Persepolis, the date of foundation, the building process, and the ominous fate of this splendid city. Achaemenid kings were buried in a place known as Naqsh-e Rustam Necropolis, which is located at a distance of 6.5 kilometers from Persepolis. sepulchres of esteemed emperors such as Darius the Great, Xerxes, Artaxerxes I, and Darius II rest in this part. The tombs situated at the foothill of Rahmat Mountain belong to Artaxerxes II and his successor. In the south side of Persepolis, there is a half-completed tomb which, according to archaeological research, belongs to Darius III. Tragically, Persepolis was demolished and pillaged in 330 BC by Alexander Macedonian. However, the ruins of this place are still standing, and archaeologists confirm the signs of fire and invasion from its ruins. In 1979, this historical enclave was registered as one of the Persian landmarks on the UNESCO World Heritage List. Thanks for watching, I hope you enjoyed this episode. Let me know your opinion in the comment section, and if you like, please subscribe to my channel and wait for new videos.